Okay, it's Atlanta's number one hip hop station, Hot 107 out and home for the Ricky Smiley Morning Show. Of course, you know it's your folk, B High Radio shouting, stepping in the building. I got a young OG in this thing, Big Korey. What's good with it, my dog?
What's up, big brother? What's good with you?
Feeling good, feeling great, man. I mean, this new banger, Game.
Yes, sir.
What's really
yes,
good
sir.
With it, my dog?
Oh, man, just a little up-tempo record, I think, man. Something to turn up to, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Just something for the summertime. With my brother Nonstop Shot, I got Hero on the beat.
Yeah.
Man, it's crazy, man. It's going crazy. I can't lie to you, B.I.
Talk to me about coming up with that banger, though, right there, man.
Man, we be in the studio every night at like 2, 3 in the morning. We be going so crazy, we might just sleep in the air mattress way.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So we was just turned up, going through tracks. My boy Hero had pulled up on me. I heard that. I'm like, ooh. So, you know, I'm rhyming to it. I put a little hook to it. And they're like, boy, you got to finish it.
Yeah.
So I just go crazy. I do my verse. I'm like, okay. Need another verse with a different voice. So my cousin come here.
Yeah.
He do his verse. It's out of here.
Now, I mean, is there going to be a project that's following this banger up?
Yes, sir, man. My world. I've been working on it for a minute, but I've been working on it for so long. I just wanted to be right. My world, that's the name of my project. I say like 9-10 songs. I already got like 4 or 5 of them done, man. Bangers.
When should we be expecting this thing, though, man?
We looking at June. Yeah. June to July, sometime right there, man. Summertime, man. Summertime.
And what's the flavor that you're going to be kicking on there, though, Korey?
We're going to be turned up.
Yeah.
We're going to do a little cooling.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And then we might just let the top down and just ride for a little minute. You know what I'm saying? We got something for the shorties.
Yeah.
We got something for the players. So, you know, we going both ways with it.
Now, I mean, on the production side of things, though, man, because I know you get busy on them keys also.
Yes, sir.
Talk to me, man. What's really good with it? Because I see you've been getting a lot of work in out here.
Yeah, production, man, has been picking up, man. I just did, I had 3 records on Triple Cross. That was Young Scooter last album came out with Young Thug and Future and Young Boy. I had a record with Young Boy called Bail Out.
That's right.
2 more other records on Death Row and I can't even think of the other name. They bangers, man. They bangers.
Exactly.
It's the last 3 records, but they going crazy. And I just had another record drop with NBA YoungBoy and Future called Right or Wrong. And I produced and engineered both of them records and, you know, recorded them. So it was a dope experience, you know what I'm saying?
Now, as a producer, man, I mean, how do you break down your production style, though, Korey?
Man, I just try to stay switching it up, man, because we in a time where you got beat makers and you got producers, you know what I'm saying? I learned from Montay.
Facts.
You know, in a couple other real OGs. So, you know, we come from NPCs, and so, you know, I just try to stay switching it up to where you can't even really tell that this is my beat. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, just stay vibing, man.
You had to put the MPC down, man, and switch it over to the total digital thing, or what?
Man,
and that's for you too, Montay, because he's still in the building, A-Time.
We are digital, but sometimes, man, I still wish I could just get that feel of the MPC.
Now, what keeps you from messing with that MP, though?
Man, it's just a long process hooking this up.
I don't like dealing with hardware no more.
Are you serious, Tay?
I done dealt with it for so long, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, I don't want to see it. It's just like me touching a turntable, an actual 1200. I don't want to.
My
thoughts of 1200s and MPCs.
Stress. How do y'all
straight
feel about
straight.
This new digital age doing being able to produce, and does it allow y'all to be able to just churn them out a lot quicker than normal?
Well, for me, you know, the average listener don't know the difference.
Yeah.
But for me, I just like whatever's still gonna sound good for me. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, you got the MPC that comes out a little warmer, but I got some little plugins that might do the same thing. You know what I'm saying? Even for Korey, though, you know what I'm saying? But it's just all about how you tweak your sound.
Yeah.
Every producer different, you know what I'm saying? You even if I had an MPC and me and her had the same 808s, you got to know how to tweak your 808 like I got mine sounding. Like, I used to have producers ask me for 808s, but I give you this 808, but you're not going to know what I did to it because I do something different to it every single time.
Put a little sauce
I'm so
on.
Sick of y'all always trying to hold these tricks in front of y'all.
It ain't tricks. It's just stuff that I learned over the, you know, over time.
Yeah,
and I engineer just like Korey, so, you know, we both know how to make our sound sound.
Yeah, so.
Korey,
what about you over there, man?
Man, I like it, man. Like I said, I'm still old school because, like I said, boy, MPCs ain't nothing like that feeling. But, you know, with all the technology, it makes it easier. You know, I'm loving that, you know, a lot of people are able to express themselves through the music, man. You know what I'm saying? It's a good time for everybody to, you know, be creative. So, you know, you can't never not like that.
So do y'all ever feel like y'all need to go ahead and get a live guitar player in there every now and then, or a live bass player in there? How does that mix in with the digital?
We did some live stuff like on Chate Project. I got my boy Brandon. He come through, play the guitar. Then we got my other boy Joe. He play the bass. You know, so if we ever need it, we got it already on deck. You know, I be around musicians all the time. Exactly. So yeah.
What about you, Korey?
I love it. I love the live side of it too, man. I still go to church just for the music. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I love the live
side. Amen. Yes, amen, brother.
Lastly, Korey, what else you got coming up next? Anything else you need to get off your chest, my dog?
Oh, man. Stay tuned for the project, man. My World. I got a big record dropping soon with a group called R2R. That's Big Block, new group.
Yeah.
I hit you up about, shout out to them with 21 Savage. Should be dropping real soon. Gonna be a cool record. Got some more stuff with Youngboy. And just a couple more records, man. We working, man. Big on records. Mm-hmm. Bringing this thing back, man. We laid the blueprint. So we just letting it be known. You know what I mean?
Well, with that being said, though, man, I mean, I gotta take it there too. When we speak of Big Oomp and we talk about the city of Atlanta, I mean, how do y'all feel like y'all sound contributed to what's going down in the A-Town right now? And then how do y'all feel about folks putting the respect on the name?
Man, the sound always come back around, you know, like with the walk it, talk it, Migos, you know, that's, you know what I mean? So, you know, it always come back around, you know, real Atlanta, you know, we laid the blueprint, boom, it's back around, you know what I mean? That's how I feel about it. It always swing back around, and then we revamping it, of course, so, you know what I mean? Big on records, baby.
And also, too, I want to say real recognize real. You know what I'm saying? We don't have to be out here saying, yeah, we started all this. We don't have to do that. You know what I'm saying? It's like people know and they recognize. Mm-hmm. Ludacris gave us a big shout out one day on Instagram, like how big on records and how we just started and set the foundation. You know, people always showing us love, man. So it's like we don't really have to just go out there and be like, man, we started this. We ain't salty about nothing.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Because we got a new blueprint coming up. Big Korey, new generation.
Starting this thing, man.
Yeah.
What's the pressure? What's the pressure level
see,
like,
listen,
Korey?
See, listen, this is what you don't understand Talk right here. This is what you feel. He been in it for a long time.
Facts.
If you hear Oomp Camp Production, that's this young man right here.
That's right.
That was him as a kid, as a young jit. So he was saying that, and that's been our stamp for years. So he's been in this music industry for a long time. So if you hear Oomp Camp Productions, you've been knowing about Big Korey. You just didn't know about Big Korey until, you know, he
Grown ass
Korey.
We working, baby. We working, man.
I can definitely dig it. How can they contact you though, my dog?
Man, Instagram, Twitter. The real Big Korey, that's me on Twitter and Instagram, Big Korey. Mm-hmm. I'm everywhere. SoundCloud, Big Korey, man. Please follow me on SoundCloud. We're going crazy. Yes, sir. My brother, B-High.
1,000, my dog. You already know what it is. Trey, give it to me again.
Yes,
B-High Radio, shout it. It's Hot 107.9, man. Let's go.